I consider these two intervals, and I will now show how to add them. I will apply the previous rule. So, minus 1 plus 2 corresponds to 1, 3 plus 5 corresponds to. What does it mean? It means that if A belongs to this interval, if B belongs to this interval, then A plus B will also belong to this interval. Now consider the multiplication. Minus 1, 3 times 2, 5. How can I compute this multiplication? I will consider all possible products of all bounds. So I will take minus 1 times 2, I obtain minus 2, minus 5, 6, 50. I will take the smallest interval which contain all these elements and I will obtain minus 5, 50. So the product of these two intervals is this interval. Now I consider the subtraction. Consider, for instance, for 5 minus, let's say, minus 1, 2. How can I compute this one? I just write that it corresponds to 4, 5 plus the opposite of this interval, which is minus 2, 1. And I apply the addition rule. It means 2 and 6. And consider a last example. Let's say 4, 6. And I will divide by minus 1 and 2. How can I compute this? I will first remark that minus 4 is feasible, but I can go up to minus infinity. And I will have also to obtain the union between 2 and infinity. This is not an interval because it corresponds to the union of the two intervals. Then I will take the smallest interval which contains this interval and I will obtain minus infinity plus infinity.